Good evening, everyone. Are you excited to be here? Welcome, graduates, family, friends, and colleagues. I'm Terry Kelly, and I'm Vice Chair of the Board of Trustees of the University of Delaware, as well as a proud Blue Hen alum. It is my honor to announce the official opening of this commencement ceremony, honoring and recognizing the achievements of the class of 2021. You may now be seated. It is my pleasure to introduce UD's Provost and Chief Academic Officer, Dr. Robin Morgan.
Good evening. I join the Board of Trustees and President Asanas in welcoming all of you to these ceremonies today. We're pleased to have several special guests with us, members of the University Board of Trustees, our distinguished faculty and leaders of the university, and Nishant Klintala, recipient of the University of Delaware Alumni Association Taylor Award, which is presented to an outstanding senior member of the graduating class. Please join me in welcoming our distinguished guest. The University of Delaware Alumni Association represents more than 190,000 proud Blue Hen alumni around the world, including all of you, the class of 2021. I invite all members of the audience, everyone here in the stadium, who are UD alumni to please stand now. That includes you, students, too. Go Blue Hens. You may be seated. We will begin today's ceremony, as we do many, with a moment of silence to remember those loved ones who are not with us today. And now, I'd like to recognize all members of the United States military, active, reserve, and retired, who are graduating today, as well as those who are faculty, staff, and guests. So anyone in the stadium who is a member of the military, active, reserve, or retired, please stand, remain standing, and let us recognize you. Stand there. And remain standing. I want to ask everyone to please stand for our national anthem, performed by Brinley Lammers, who is receiving a Bachelor of Music degree today.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that
UD to me means community.
Starting point.
It's opportunity.
Legacy.
UD means adventure.
UD is family.
I never actually want to leave. It's just home.
When I looked at the campus and the green, you know, it's something straight out of a movie for me.
I was in awe. I thought everything was absolutely gorgeous and beautiful.
Coming here from high school was definitely an adjustment. I came from classes with 15 to 25 kids, and I stepped into lecture halls of 100 plus kids.
Within the first couple weeks, I settled in, made a lot of new friends, and just decided to be as outgoing as I could.
I spent a lot of my time on campus on the green, actually. Perkins Student Center always felt like a home away from home, in a way.
I spent all of my time in the ice lab, I have to say, when it was still open. We would actually close it out. The security guards would have to come in and be like, it's actually closing time.
My favorite event was definitely UDance. UDance holds a very close home for me, a very close place to my heart.
There's nothing like the entire campus coming together for such a good cause and doing something as crazy and as fun as standing on their feet for 12 hours.
I had a class that was, it's literally called Research Experience. And we literally chartered a research cruise and we went out on the boat. We were doing our research all day. I was like, this is awesome. Like, this is what I want my life to be. I could do this for the rest of my life. I love this.
Right before COVID happened, we had a game in like mid-February. It was on national TV against Towson, and we sold out the Bob, and it was probably my most memorable game.
I just gonna miss all the people that I got to know here.
I think I'll just miss the constant support from friends, the constant help, the support from the professors. It's gonna be weird living on my own. I'm not gonna know what to do.
I think that UD prepared me for what I'm about to step into next with my job, but definitely nervous because, like, I'm leaving and, like, all my friends, we're all separating.
I can't think of a single person that comes into college as a freshman and then by senior year hasn't drastically changed in some way, shape, or form.
To think that, you know, 4 years of accomplishments, of things that I never imagined I would have been able to do, and I know I wouldn't have been able to if I didn't come to this university and step foot on this campus.
I have definitely learned to become a better leader, all thanks to the classes and my advisors and my teachers.
My friends and family really helped me to get to this point that I am. They're always there to support me.
My family is definitely a big support system, because without them, I wouldn't be here.
This is a day that we've all been looking forward to for the past, 20 years of our lives, and it's really surreal that we're all here together.
Despite the pandemic, we all managed to make it to this point. I wish everyone a very much successful life.
I'm proud because we made it.
If we can get through this, we can get through anything.
It's not just 4 years, it's for life.
Blue hands forever.
Blue hands forever.
Blue hands forever.
No one at the University of Delaware hoped for an in-person commencement more than our president. And here we are now together. It's a little iffy this evening, but bear with us. As has been true for this entire year, your safety is our first concern, but we are going to try to recognize you in the best possible way. And at this time, it is my honor to introduce the 28th president of the University of Delaware, Dennis Asanas.
Class of 2021, good evening. Hello, blue hands. What a wonderful day to graduate. Even a little rain won't stand in the way because you're fabulous and you're going to graduate in a few minutes. I'm so, so happy to see you. And I'm thrilled that we could be together here in person and online with your families and friends. I have truly missed these special campus events, and I know you have too. It's been a challenging time for all of us, and your experience at UD has been unlike any other in our 278-year treasured history. Reaching this moment has required an incredible level of perseverance, not only in your academic commitments, but also in your identity as a Blue Hen. It was your indomitable spirit and your constant drive to succeed that helped you overcome unprecedented obstacles. Together, you share a unique bond as the University of Delaware class of 2021. Let me be among the first to congratulate you on reaching this milestone in your lives. Well done. So many of you have distinguished yourselves through your academic and research pursuits, through your community service, through your athletic accomplishments. And you did it while the world around us was changing moment by moment. On behalf of your professors and our entire staff and administration at the university, I want to say how proud we are of you and how inspired we are by your true Blue Hen spirit. I want to recognize the hard work of all our graduates throughout your time at UD. As I call on your group, please stand and remain standing. And please hold your applause until the end. If your academic achievements earn you a scholarship or award, please stand up now. Come on, there must be some who earned an award. Very good, very good. If you studied in another country, or if you work with a professor or a research project, please stand. No, remain standing. The rest of you remain standing. Hey, you must be engineers, right? If you transform a great idea into a business or a nonprofit, or if you help your community during these challenging times through a service organization or you dance, please stand. If you were a proud Blue Hen athlete, please stand. In case there is somebody still sitting, I've got one more for you. If you've ever pulled an all-nighter to finish a project or prepare for a big test, please stand up now. All right. Let's give all our graduates, our excellent graduates, a big round of applause. Okay, clearly you've worked hard, so you can sit down for now. As you reflect on everything you have learned and accomplished at UD, I hope that you will notice that your greatest moments were probably associated with your greatest challenges. Times when you were faced with a complex problem that seemed impossible to solve. There's certainly been a lot of those lately, and I hope that you continue to draw on the skills, the values, and the mindset that carried you through these challenges. You have shown that you are resilient. You had to adapt quickly and repeatedly to stay on the path to success that led you here today. You demonstrated admirable endurance and fortitude, reaching deep inside yourself to draw on a strength that maybe you didn't even know that you possessed. You'll no doubt face many more challenges in your lives, and now you know that you have the determination and resolve to overcome them. And you reached this moment together. You worked in teams, collaborating to combine your knowledge and abilities to achieve far more than you could do by yourselves. You sought the wisdom of your mentors to help you and guide you and encourage you along the way. Most impressive, I know that you sacrificed the health and safety, you sacrificed to protect the health and safety of those around you. Good joke, right? Not only your friends and families, but everyone in your community. I'm truly grateful for everything you did to support and care for one another. Indeed, I believe we have all felt a renewed sense of gratitude in our lives. We saw how quickly our circumstances, our expectations can change sometimes. We've learned to appreciate the good things we have, and we're reminded that we all have the power to advocate for reform when it's needed. In many ways, the lessons you have learned about resilience, teamwork, and gratitude have uniquely prepared you, the class of 2021, to succeed. The world is rapidly changing, and you've shown that you can change with it. Our society needs new ways of thinking, and you possess an innovative spirit. And we need to take care of each other, something you've demonstrated throughout your time at UD. I want you to keep educating your mind and your heart, because as Aristotle said, knowing yourself is the beginning of all wisdom. To know yourself is to believe in yourself, to believe in the limitless possibilities ahead, and to seize the opportunities where you can to truly make a difference in the world. Above all, if you persevere, you work together, and you appreciate what you have and what needs to change, you are unstoppable. We, your friends, your families, your professors, and everyone here at the University of Delaware believe in you. I'm extremely optimistic about the future, knowing that the class of 2021 will be out there changing the world. Congratulations! You are blue hands forever! And now we have a message from a very special blue hand who reminds us all of the limitless potential of a UD degree, and you know where that could take you.
Hello, graduates, Dr. Asanas and Laney, John Cochran, and members of the Board of Trustees, thank you. Thank you for all you do. And to all my fellow blue hands, your family, friends, all of you, congratulations. I'm so proud of you and so happy to welcome you to the University of Delaware alumni family. For me and Jill, my sister, my brother, the whole family, we make no bones about the pride we have in the University of Delaware. Delaware didn't just educate us, it opened doors, it gave us a greater sense of life's possibilities. I had great professors, Dr. Dolan, Dr. Ingersoll, Dr. Monroe, Dr. Bennett, and so many others, who instilled in me the confidence that I could make sense of an uncertain world, that I could do anything if I worked at it hard enough, even possibly being President of the United States. No graduating class gets to choose the world in which they graduate. Every class enters the history of the nation up to the point that has been written by others. But few classes, once in every few generations, enters at a point in our history where it actually has a chance to change the trajectory of the country. Just 3 years after I stood where you're standing, two of my political heroes, Dr. King and Robert Kennedy, were gunned down. The Vietnam War divided the nation and divided families. We're in the midst of a great movement for civil rights, women's rights, and environmental rights. We faced an inflection point, and we did our best to seize that moment because things were changing so rapidly. And now, you face another inflection point. As we put this pandemic behind us, rebuild our economy, root out systemic racism, and tackle climate change, we're addressing the great crises of our time with a greater sense of purpose than ever before. And because of you, your generation, I've never been more optimistic about the future than I am today. You represent one of the most gifted and talented and well-educated generations in American history. And you're going to see more change in the next 10 years than you saw and we saw in the last 50 years. But it's going to be up to you. It's going to be up to you to translate that unprecedented change into a greater measure of happiness and prosperity for not only you and our nation, but for the world around you. And I know you will. The Irish poet Seamus Heaney once wrote, "History says, don't hope on this side of the grave, but then, once in a lifetime, the longed-for tidal wave of justice can rise up, and hope and history can rhyme." Graduates, you have a chance to make hope and history rhyme. So congratulations. Go out and do what you can. May God bless you and your families.
You know, he is in town all weekend. I think he's heading to Bethany Beach. The honorary degree is the highest academic honor bestowed by the University of Delaware and is reserved as recognition of true distinction. This year, we're privileged to bestow the university's highest honor on five outstanding individuals who make up the university's honorary degree class of 2021. We are fortunate that one of our honorees is present for this ceremony today, so I ask John Anderson to stand now and be recognized. We had the opportunity to recognize him earlier, but I want to make a couple comments. Dr. John Anderson is currently president of the National Academy of Engineering and former president of the Illinois Institute of Technology. He had a prestigious career as a university academic, an administrator, and as a proud Blue Hen alumnus. Congratulations.
Thank you,
Bert. I'd also like to recognize four other of our honorees. So we have Dr. Patricia Dione, trustee distinguished professor emerita of biological sciences at UD and a recipient of the university's Francis Allison Award. A. Gilchrist Sparks, a leader in the field of corporate law who served 16 years on the U of D Board of Trustees. Dan Rich, university professor of public policy, director of the Community Engagement Initiative at U of D, and a member of the campus community for 50 years. And lastly, Ty Jones, alumnus and award-winning producing artistic director of the Classical Theater of Harlem. Please join me in a round of applause for all of our honorary degree recipients this year. At this time, please welcome Dr. Brian Hansen, representing the faculty of the University of Delaware.
Good evening. As a professor of geography and spatial sciences, I'm also honored to serve as an officer of the Faculty Senate. The education you received here at UD mostly resulted from your interactions with the more than 1,300 faculty of this institution. The professors create knowledge, and they pass it on to you by designing courses and teaching them, designing curricula for your degree programs, finding research experiences for you in their labs and in their field programs, and doing their best to mentor you. When you reach the milestones that you're celebrating today, I can also assure you that we are proud of you. So, on behalf of the entire faculty of the University of Delaware, I am proud and honored to recommend all of you members of the class of 2021 for the conferral of your degrees this evening. Congratulations.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Calvin Keeler, and I am honored to serve as the interim dean of the College of Agriculture and Natural Resources, the best job in the world. On behalf of the entire college, I am pleased to present candidates for the following degrees: Bachelor of Science, Honors Bachelor of Science, Master of Arts, Master of Science, and Doctor of Philosophy. President Asanas, I have the distinct honor to present to you these candidates for degrees from the College of Agriculture and Natural Resources. Rise. Rise. Louder.
Good evening. I am Dr. Estella Atukwana, Dean of the College of Earth, Ocean, and Environment, where our graduates seek to solve Earth's grand challenges, such as climate change, energy, water, and food security, for the benefit of society. I am pleased to present to you our graduates from our college, Bachelor of Science, Bachelors of Art, Masters of Science, and Doctor of Philosophy. Will the degree recipients please rise?
Good evening. I'm Levi Thompson, and I'm not only a University of Delaware graduate, I'm the fortunate person to serve as Dean of the College of Engineering. On behalf of our college, I'm pleased to present to you the candidates for the following degrees. That's the tag from my new mask. Bachelor degrees in Engineering, Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Science, Honors Bachelor degrees in Engineering, Honors Bachelor's degree of Arts, and Honors Bachelor degree of Science. Master of Science, Doctor of Philosophy. President Asanas, I have the distinct honor to present to you these candidates for degrees in the College of Engineering.
Thank you, Dean Thompson. Thank you, Dean Atequana. Thank you, Dean Killer. And now, under the authority of the faculty and the Board of Trustees of the University of Delaware, I have the honor and privilege of conferring upon you, the amazing members of the class of 2021, the respective bachelor's, honors bachelor's, master's, and doctoral degrees for which you have been individually recommended. And I do declare you entitled to all the rights, honors, and privileges to those degrees appertaining throughout the world. Congratulations. And now, the moment that you've been waiting for. Would all members of the class of 2021 please stand? I now call upon each of you to symbolize this important milestone and achievement by moving the tassel on your mortarboard from the right to the left, thereby signifying that you are now a graduate of the University of Delaware. Congratulations. Now keep standing for a minute. We're not quite done yet. We need to take the selfie of the class with me. Please be seated. We have many people to thank for this day, especially our outstanding faculty, staff, and alumni who inspire and advance this vibrant community every day. We'd also like to thank all the volunteers and volunteer marshals who work hard to plan this special commencement ceremony. Let's give them a round of applause. Of course, none of you would be here today without the love and support of your families and friends who have stood by you and cheered you on in your journey at UD. Graduates, please give your families and friends a warm round of applause. And now I would ask you all to stand for the University of Delaware alma mater.